Hey guys, it's Mike Chen. A lot of feedback I've gotten over the years about cooking traditional Chinese food is that people really have a hard time even taking the first step, going to an Asian, or in this case, a Chinese supermarket, because it could be insanely intimidating. Like, what should you be looking for? What if you can't read the labels? There's a ton of things. I get it, it's completely overwhelming. That's why in this video, we're gonna go to a Chinese supermarket and we're gonna walk around, and I'm gonna introduce to you some of my favorite ingredients where you should be looking for, some of the most useful kitchen utensils, and honestly, a Chinese supermarket, it's kind of like, you know, kind of where I like to hang out, you know, on Friday nights or, you know, any night, just fun for me. So let's go. Let me show you around.
Right now I'm in front of the Da Tang supermarket near my house. It's the only Chinese supermarket around my house. It's a smaller one, but it has most everything I need for my kitchen. Let me show you. The first thing I do when I head into a Chinese supermarket is try to stay away from the ramen aisle, because that's always dangerous. But let me show you some of the spices I gotta have in my kitchen. Okay, this is probably the most intimidating aisle in most Chinese supermarkets, because there's just so much sauces and spices. And let's just start from the beginning. So first of all, sesame sauce. This is a very versatile, very amazingly tasting sauce that I always keep on hand, not only because it's a vital essential ingredient in any hot pot dipping sauce, and I eat hot pot a lot, but this is also a great way to enhance noodle dishes. I mean, probably not good with like a marinara sauce, but most any Asian noodle recipe will go great with this. This is also something I have to have multiple jars of always. It's fermented bean curd. Okay, that might sound really gross. Fermented bean curd. It's actually really good. It's fermented tofu, and this one, this is a red one, you see. This one, it's just basically food coloring and fermented tofu, but this has so many functions. First of all, if you just want a simple rice dish, you just have a rice cooker, you have some rice, and you have this in the fridge, that's already a pretty darn good meal. And because this goes great with any rice dish where it's just plain rice. And also the juice is really good to cook it with different types of meat. If you want the meat to have that nice roasted barbecue-y glow, slightly radioactive color looking artificial glow. Also, great sauce to have, Sichuan spicy noodle sauce. Boil some pasta, some noodles, whatever, throw some of the sauce on. Instant classic dinner, not much to it. Sauce and noodles makes a great meal. Ooh, I love this. Jianmu jiang, spicy hot mustard sauce. The Chinese jianmu, or mustard sauce, is intense. Like a single drop of it might burn a hole through your stomach. But mix that with a little sliced carrots, cucumbers, a little bit of rice noodles, you're gonna have yourself a deliciously spicy salad that's gonna also clear your sinuses. Another essential sauce that really needs no introduction, the sriracha. Basically, put this on everything, like everything. Maybe not ice. Yeah, maybe ice cream could work as well. Just such a versatile sauce. In every single Chinese supermarket, you're gonna have a huge selection of Chinese hot oil. So, oh, they make this in-house. You're not gonna buy this. Actually, Luke, it's pretty good. And the most famous is, of course, Lao Gan Ma, old dry mom, literal translation. So, this is a soybean paste. A lot of people don't know what to do with this, but this is a transformative ingredient for so many dishes. Soybean paste in general has such an earthy, robust flavor, and it goes great with literally everything you want to cook, especially stir-fried dishes. So like, for example, if you want to make vegetables sing brighter, if you want the meat to be savorier, if you want to be the culinary hero to your entire family, you get this. Like, basically anything you're cooking, stir-fried vegetables, stir-fried meat, essentially anything stir-fried, add this sauce. It's gonna create great earthy flavor that's gonna add so much substance to what you're already cooking. This sauce is not designed to bring out the natural flavor of the ingredients. So if you just pick some heirloom tomatoes from the garden you grew in your backyard, don't slather the sauce over it. This is really meant to kind of enhance the savoriness of the meats and add that extra savory flavor to the vegetables as well. And this is really something that it goes great with rice. It goes great with noodles. This is an essential ingredient to jiajiaomian, which is one of the all-time best Asian noodle dishes. So always keep this thing around. Another dish here that really doesn't get enough credit is the tianmianjiang. It's basically the sweet bean paste. There are so many things you could do with this. If you're making, for example, a sandwich or even better, a wrap, this is a great sauce to add. It's a little sweet, but so fragrant. And this is gonna be an essential ingredient to a dish we're making later. It's gonna be really fun. You're gonna love this dish. I love it. It's one of the most popular street food dishes in China. And it all revolves around this. Sesame oil. I have about 3 bottles of this in my kitchen because I add this on basically everything. If you want anything to give it a little extra aroma, this is it. Any stir-fry dish, again, any stir-fry dish, noodles, soups, this is gonna add that gorgeous sesame aroma to all those dishes. And I love adding this to my salads, you know, the few times I eat salads, and also love it in my hot oil. Hoisin sauce, something else that's really good with stir fry, something else you wanna add into your sandwich or your wrap, you wanna dip your meat in anything, you wanna dip your vegetables in anything, this is it. You can steam some vegetables, throw some of this stuff on top, it'll make it great. It says haixianjiang in Chinese, which means like seafood sauce. There's really nothing fishy about this. There's nothing fishy about it, it's legit. No fishiness to it, it's legit sauce. Ooh. Here we go. We're at the soy sauce and vinegar aisle, and this confuses a lot of people because there are a ton of soy sauces and vinegar. Oh, and also oyster sauce. So got the whole family here, whole sauce family. There are so many different types of soy sauces out there, but in Chinese cooking, we really only utilize 2 different types, dark soy sauce and light soy sauce. All right, light and dark soy sauce. Now the dark soy sauce, it's not as salty as the light soy sauce. So if you want more flavor in terms of just making your food saltier, the light soy sauce is how you do it. The dark soy sauce, what it does is it adds that beautiful color to your meat or whatever you're stir frying in your wok. So this thing is gonna add a lot of umaminess and a lot of color without so much of the salt flavor. Saltiness is the light one, but you really do need both. Oyster sauce is probably one of the most versatile of all sauces in Chinese cooking. Huge umami flavor, anything it touches. This thing, steam any vegetable, put it on top, good meal. Fry an egg, put it on top, great breakfast. Put it on any of the meats you're cooking, the meat is gonna thank you, the flavor, it's gonna just give you something that's not just salty, right? It's gonna give you something really, really, really deep. And it's an oyster sauce, but don't let that scare you. It's really, again, there's nothing fishy about it. You can't really even taste the oysters. It's really good adding that extra depth in basically any dish you cook. All right, onto the vinegar family. So in Chinese cooking, there are typically 2 types of vinegars we deal with. We have the white vinegar and we have the dark vinegar. The white vinegar, typically we use rice vinegar. This is something we want to add to dishes that we don't want to really modify the color. It's white vinegar, so it's not gonna really mess with the color, but it is gonna add a lot of acidity. And this is pretty acidic. Compare this to the Chinese black vinegar. Chinese people, we have multiple bottles of this in our kitchens. There are people in China that will straight up drink this out of the bottle. I am not kidding you. And because this thing, not only it adds that vinegar flavor, but it adds so much depth because this is aged vinegar and it has a lot of umami flavor. So if you want your dishes to not just taste sour, but vinegary and just you want people to ooh and ah at your food, you want that extra depth, this is the way to go. But you do need both, because there are dishes that, for example, Chinese stir-fried potatoes, you don't want the color of the dish to change. You gotta utilize the white vinegar because this will darken your food up. One more thing in this aisle you have to have in your kitchen is Chinese cooking wine. And this is the brand basically everybody uses, Shaoxing cooking wine. There is a lot of recipes that calls for the use of this because in cooking, we deal a lot with pork. And oftentimes pork, it comes with a little gaminess, a little smelly flavor if you don't clean it perfectly. And this basically kills all that. Also fish, you wanna kill the fishiness. This is just a great way to eliminate any of that funk from your food. Now comes to my favorite thing, the dried chilies. You're gonna see these come in a couple of different forms. So you got the dry chilies that you see the whole chilies. Then you have them kind of crushed up. I gotta have both because they do different things. The crushed up ones, they make great chili oil, hot oil. It's essential. But the thing with this is sometimes you don't want it to be in your stir fry. Sometimes you want the flavor without the mess. That's why these are great. So if you want to stir fry something, toss a couple of these things in. It's going to provide a little nuance. It's going to make the dish look better, provide those streaks of red color, and it's going to give off a lot of heat. Also, to me, it's like an early warning system. If you see a dish with a bunch of these in there, you know it's going to be spicy. And then it'll also keep people who don't eat spicy away from your dish. You know what I'm saying? All right, so this is something else that's really overwhelming to a lot of people, the spice aisle. Now, Chinese spices is just so many. But it's not like Indian food where there's some dishes we have like 20 spices in there. Those typically don't exist. But the spices we love to use, one is dried Sichuan peppercorn. If you're a spice head, you gotta get this because spice is great. Spice and numbing, that's miraculous. All right, that's harmony. That's how food should be. And this is basically the entire foundation of Sichuan cooking, spicy and nummy. When I make meat dishes, I add this in, and this usually always goes great with, like I said, the chilies. All right, these two together, it's perfect. Star anise. Star anise is something that every single Chinese person has in their kitchen. And this ingredient releases a very strong aroma. Typically, you only need like a couple. That's it. Like you can smell this thing from like a block away, and it's not a bad smell. It's a little medicinal and infuses like this crazy aroma, very unique aroma. I use this a lot making my tea eggs. I use this a lot making big chunks of pork dishes or beef dishes. You want it to have aroma. This is what does it. These two are probably my favorite powder spices. The cumin powder. This is very, I feel like very underappreciated in most cooking. If you have a barbecue, if you love barbecuing, burger, ribs, whatever it is, add this onto the barbecue. It's gonna drive people crazy. Just the smell of it will drive people crazy. Really simple dish, you know, take some slices of beef, slices of green pepper, add some of this, add some chili powder. It's gonna completely change your dish. This just adds such an incredibly unique aromatic spice flavor. And this again pairs very well with chili powder. This is Chinese five spice. It's great for eggs, for pork, for beef, whenever you're trying to marinate something. This is basically in every single marinade in Chinese cooking. And the spices here include fennel, includes star anise, some ginger, some cloves. It's basically everything we love in one pack. This is something Chinese people use when we're really lazy, but I actually love it. It's chicken bouillon powder. Can I say it? This is like the secret ingredients to most Chinese cooks. I'm just gonna say that. Like, this is what makes a lot of dishes that you had at your Chinese friends' house taste really delicious is this, because it does add so much rich flavor to everything. I like using this instead of salt. So in these cooking courses, if you just wanna use this instead of salt, your food will taste better than mine. I mean, your mouth's gonna be more dry because this has MSG, but it tastes better. Oh, one more thing I almost forgot. This is so important. White pepper powder. Make sure you get one of these. This is nothing like the pepper that you find in the West, okay? This is a miracle worker for soups. If you want a little peppery flavor, this will give you a bomb of pepper flavor. A good bomb, not the bad ones. Is there a bad, good book? It's great, okay? This is great if you wanna stew anything, stew any meat, you want a little spicy. I add white pepper to basically all my soups. So good. Oh, one last thing I totally forgot. Oh, not that. This is perhaps the love I have for this. I know I love a lot of stuff here, but God, this is so good. This is five spice black bean sauce. This is a sauce that really is never utilized much outside of Asian cooking, but trust me, you're cooking some chicken, some pork, some beef, add some of this. Guys, put this over rice. Your family is gonna call you a hero from now until the end of time, okay? We're gonna see a lot of this. This is the if you wanna eat Chinese food but don't wanna work too hard aisle. So it has everything you need. The frozen aisles at Chinese supermarkets is something I love to explore because a lot of times these fruits taste pretty good. There's red bean cakes I love. Actually, I do really like these scallion pancakes. I mean, they give you the dough, which is not cooked. You cook it yourself. It takes about a couple minutes and it tastes really good. Not as good as if you cooked it yourself, but still for a frozen item, it's really good. The one thing I do always get at a frozen goods aisle is some wonton wrappers. And I get a couple of different kinds. There's so many things you could do with wonton wrappers that does not involve a wonton. You can literally slice these in ribbons, drop them in oil, and then eat them as a cracker. But we're gonna do something really special with these for one of our recipes, but really, really useful ingredient to have around. Of course, you have your frozen dumplings, frozen wontons. Most frozen dumplings aren't really even that bad. The one thing I love at Chinese supermarkets and supermarkets in general, and this is a Korean thing, but get yourself some bologna. This thing's amazing. Also, if you never had it, mochi ice cream, that's gonna change the way you see ice cream forever. And these fishy ice cream things, God, I love these. I mean, just, oh. But before I leave the frozen goods aisle, at most Chinese supermarkets, you're gonna find an aisle or frozen section serving slices of beef. This is for your hot pot. This is ingredients for your hot pot. These are thinly sliced brisket and lamb. And you're gonna see noodles here, fish balls. That's what these are, different types of meatballs. This I think is a pork ball. There's also fish balls, shrimp balls, squid balls, whatever else balls you want. A Chinese supermarket has it in their frozen goods section. If you're wondering what these are basically all for hot pots, or soups, or noodles. So if you ever want to cook some noodles, you want to throw some of these meatballs in there, just take it out of the package, boil it, toss it into your dish. It's going to taste great. Okay. You're going to find this install basically in every single Chinese supermarket. You're going to see something like this. And this is just the easiest way to make yourself a hot pot. Hot pot is something I talk about a lot in my videos. Basically, it's the pot of boiling broth. It's seasoned. You put just dozens of ingredients around it. You dip it inside. It's kind of like a Chinese fondue. And this is where it starts. So, Xiaofeiyang is one of my favorites. You get a spicy version or a non-spicy version. Boil your water, toss this in, and just start throwing in random vegetables and meats. Not all meats. All right, don't throw like a rib in there. All right, throw the thin sliced meat I showed you guys before. This, fuzu. This is another dish I cannot have hot pot without. I don't mean to call it a dish, an ingredient. It's basically dry tofu skin. And of course you can't eat it like this. It's, you know, it's gonna cut you up. Soak these in water. They're gonna turn incredibly soft and elasticy because they have a nice chewy texture. But these, it's got great tofu taste. And if you wanna get your tofu nutrients in, but you don't like it, that it's so soft, this is fantastic because it's got a nice texture and the flavor is remarkable. If you stir fry this with something, put it in a soup, it's gonna soak up all that juice. Like I said, when I'm eating hot pot, can't eat it without this.